Hey guys, today we're going to be finishing up the 179cc killer tiller engine. I've been waiting for these billet guide plates to come in. These are the pushrod guide plates. And I finally found a place that had some. Make sure you guys stick around, because at the end of this video we're going to get a sneak peek of the next engine coming. But first, let's get this thing taken care of and get this valve cover off, because I'm wanting to put those 1.3 to 1 ratio rockers in there. And if you remember the last video, we couldn't get them in there because we were short on that billet guide plate. A stock guide plate would not work. And all the normal places I ordered, I couldn't find any. So I finally found a place that had them, and I bought 3 or 4 to keep on hand, because it seems like it's hard to find parts anymore. But yeah, I'm going to save this valve cover gasket if I can. Try not to tear it. And we'll reuse that. Still looks okay. Now I've got to get these old rockers off here, and I'm just going to try to zip them off quick as I can. I'll spin these things off here by hand. Hopefully get them out here pretty quick. Yeah. But now that 1.3 to 1 ratio rocker, those will give me a lot more lift on this stock camshaft. But I'm not going to throw these away. I'm going to save these stock rocker arms, because, you know, hey, you got to have spares. And the studs on these are 12 millimeter socket size. I just pull those two studs out and lift that valve guide. There we go. Retainer, excuse me. Push rod retainer, my bad. And I'm going to install this billet one in here. Now, these are just long slot push rod guides, and they'll keep the rockers from wiggling around. Now, I'm not putting any Loctite on these studs, guys. If you want to put them on yours, you can. But, you know, I've not had any of these come loose, so I just kind of snug them down good. But, yeah, with the stock guide plate, it wouldn't let the push rod as close to the stud as it needed to be. Those 1.3 to 1 rockers located the push rod closer to the stud, and the guide plate wouldn't let it go. Now, these have an extended slot, so yeah, they'll let it get up there as close as it needs to be, and they'll still hold the push rod in place. And that's an issue on these. You really need the guide plates, because these rockers have the rounded tips on them, and that means they kind of, yeah, that's a big difference in this. They're a lot shorter, and they have the rounded tips, so that means they'll kind of wiggle to the left and to the right. Now, there's another type of rocker arm you can get, has the square tip rockers, and those don't wiggle on the valve stem as much. But, you know, I kind of like these, so, you know, hey, I'm going to stick with them. And I'm just going to use a flat screwdriver here to put my push rod up there and in the guide plate, and then run this retaining nut down, my rocker nut. I'll put the retaining nut on afterwards. We'll do the same thing on the other side. And it's kind of tedious, but, you know, just hang in there. All you guys with big fingers, don't feel like you're the Lone Ranger. I know what you're feeling. Now, the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to try to turn this over, and it'd have been better if I'd pulled the plug out. But I'm running it through the cycles, running it through the intake power. Let's see, there we go. After you get, when you get it up on the compression stroke, right after the top dead center, right before top dead center, or right after top dead center, excuse me, on the compression stroke, the exhaust valve will kind of kick open and down. Now that is your compression release on the exhaust cam low. And right as soon as that kicks over and you see that exhaust rocker open a little bit and then close back down, as soon as it closes back down, just stop. Now I'm going to set mine. You can set yours whatever you need to, but I'm setting mine at 3. But after it makes that cycle and you just bump that compression release on the exhaust valve, you're free to set both valves at the same time. And this is a non-Hemi head, and you know, these are frustrating, guys. You know, I know they're frustrating for me too, but just try to make it starting out with a little loose, and then when you tighten it down, maybe it'll work good for you. I have bad luck with them. It seems like every time it always gets too tight on me. But, you know, just do what you can do. And on these you take a 14 millimeter for the rocker. Excuse me, the rocker arm nut. And it's a 10 millimeter for the lock nut. And it got too tight on me, so I'm having to back it off a little bit. And, you know, just be patient. I know it can be frustrating, but you'll get it. Just loosen your lock nut, back it up, wiggle the rocker a little bit, and just keep backing it up a little bit at a time until you can get your feeler gauge in there. And these are, yeah, a little frustrating, but you know, you'll get it. You'll get it. You know, don't give up on it. You know, you'll feel like you've backed it off and it's still tight. You know, it doesn't make sense, but you know, it's okay. Just make sure you wiggle your rockers, especially these round tip rockers. You got to wiggle those. Make sure it's set it centered on the valve stem. And I'm going to try it again. I've got this one where I've got a really loose feel on the feeler gauge there on the intake, and I'm going to run this down and it's probably going to get too tight on me. Well, wonders never cease. Yeah, it's too tight. So, I wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. I still can't get that feeler gauge down in there. So, let's start loosening them up a little bit. Now, this one actually kind of, the lock nut kind of stuck and it turned the adjusting nut. So, be okay. I get it right there. We'll see. And did I get it? I think I can fit it in there. Hey. Now I'm going to run it through a cycle. And yeah, you know, it's better if you take your spark plug out. It's better, guys. I just left mine in because, you know, it didn't really bother me that much. But as soon as you see that exhaust valve bump on the compression release, that's where you stop. And, you know, the reason why I'm going through and checking these again, because remember, guys, when we assembled this thing, I used that really thick lube on that camshaft. So you got to kind of watch. And once again, my intake valve, after I've rotated it, it's out of adjustment just a little bit. It's a little loose, so I'm going to try to turn it a little bit and hope and pray I don't tighten it down too much. What we got here? Uh-oh. Yeah, I did. I tightened it down too much. So that's okay. Sorry, I'll just back it up just a hair. Tightening back down. No big deal. That feels pretty good right there. Yeah. All right. I think we got it. Let's see if we can get this valve cover back on. And because I'm using those 1.3:1 ratio rockers, I'm going to use a thicker valve cover gasket, and I'm going to stack them. Now this one is about 58 thousand, something like that. I'm going to stack that right on top of the stock valve cover gasket. And that'll put me up, you know, around 60 thousandths higher than what the valve cover was before. And ironically, you know, that's just about the same amount of lift that I'm going to be putting in to the valve. So, hey, this should work out okay. When you tighten these valve cover bolts down, guys, just kind of snug them down. Don't get overly excited with them because, you know, you can make a valve cover leak if you tighten these down too tight. I'll just stick my hose back on there. Should be good to go. Alrighty. Now, I did raise that tank up and get some fuel in the carburetor. Let's see, pull my little key switch thing out here. And you know, I did not connect that during ground wireless. Okay, that's a list of things to do. I have to put the ground wire back on. But now, coming up next, I'm going to have to clean off the workbench a little bit more here. But I've got another new engine in that I wanted to start checking out. And we're going to take a look at this one real soon. I'll have the video done hopefully within the next day or two and have it uploaded. Oh, sorry guys, I'm about to knock the camera over here. But now this one is a little different. It's the Anbull 223cc engine. And I wanted to kind of check it out and see what we had here. Not a bad looking engine. And it's got some surprises. Stay tuned for those. That's all I got for today, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.